Hi, I will assemble HackRF Portapack H2 and show you two most common problem fixes with this build on the end of the video. These two boards are connected together with three row of connectors, and this little guy is for the battery. Portapack has display, 5 buttons and this rotating knob. HackRF board has shielded radio components, SMD antenna connectors that I already protected with captain tape. And this battery will power it up. I did order this transparent cover, and it came with all hardware needed. Links in description. So yeah, here we have 4 standoff tangies for PCB and 8 plastic screws. Let me place battery on its place and connect 2 PCBs together. I have to be careful and not to damage anything. Battery can go deeper and it can be connected. This is nice sandwich. Well, hacking sandwich. Time for little standoffs. They will protect PCBs from flexing and also they will hold all together. I mean, front and back covers. One is a bit loose, so I will use a little bit of vibratie to hold it on its place. Voila! Ready to go in. Top connector has to go through and bottom ones will just click in, like so. Simple and functional. I realized that my buttons have little covers on them, so let's remove those first and front cover can be placed on. Headphone port first and boom! Screw in those plasticky screws, to be precise, 8 of them. I will be doing more HackRF and Flipper Zero videos, so stick around, comment what you want to see. Buttons cover on? I think they will be misplaced very soon. Anyway, let's secure SMD connectors for antennas. Here I will use again vibratie and will hand tie those nuts. Lastly, rotating knob will get this nice wheel cover. Push it on, it will turn on the HackRF. Oh yeah, it is looking so cool. Display is on and all other things. Perfect. So, promised issues fixes. If you have no display, press and hold left button with power knob for few seconds and it will fix your display, for sure. And if your button is not working, press and hold middle button with power knob for few seconds and that will bring your button response back. Thanks for watching and see you next time.